been sitting on the charts like a beast there. My last album spent 52 weeks there. Almost finished with the second, you should be scared.
What's going on YouTube? This is Shahada Shoboj back once again from Gadget Fielder channel. And in this video, I'm going to review the Pure Nexus ROM for Moto G5 Plus. I will talk about features, performance and bugs of this ROM. So guys, sit back, relax and enjoy the show. So before going for review, in this channel we cover gadget reviews, apps and game reviews and custom ROM reviews just like this one. So if you are new here, consider subscribing. So any further ado, let's go ahead and see what we have got in this ROM. This is the latest version of Pure Nexus ROM. This ROM comes with 5th July 2017 security patch and this is the latest patch. Also, it is based on Android Nougat 7.1.2. This ROM is also based on Lineage OS, as well as the kernel they are using is custom kernel, which is Lineage OS kernel. So in the settings menu, there is Pure Nexus settings. Here you will get all of the tweaks or customization of this ROM. First, there is lock screen. Here you can customize lock screen items, like you can set double tap anywhere to sleep, long press power for torch, disable lock screen media art and disable fingerprint sensor vibration option. Then there is notification drawer. Here you will get quick settings pull down, smart pull down of no ongoing, no dismissible and no notifications mode. Advanced quick settings, easy toggle, brightness slider on off toggle and ability to set contextual or custom header images are there in the notification drawer. After that you will find recent apps. Here you can set immersive recent mode, kill all fab options. Then there is status bar. You can customize battery, clock, network traffic, brightness control, etc. After that, there is navigation bar for enabling and disabling soft keys, as well as you will get nav bar animation toggle, which is really nice. Then you have that option to disable power menu on secure lock and add or remove some options to the power menu. You will get 3-finger swipe for screenshot toggle, as well as there is LED controls for battery and notifications. All of this you can use OMS Substratum theme engine, and this is not end. You will get more features for customizing. I can't show you all of this because the long timing of the video. The performance of this ROM is good. This ROM is pretty much smooth and fast. I didn't see any lag there. Gaming performance is also awesome. All gestures works really good. Battery backup is good. I am satisfied with the battery performance. The camera of this ROM is normal. You will get lots of options. Front camera is pretty much fine, but the back camera is little noisy. Honestly, I didn't find any bug in this ROM. I think it's pretty much stable. All the gestures works good. This ROM is very stable. You can use it as your daily driver. So guys, that's pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys want to see this kind of ROM reviews for Moto G5 Plus, like this video, subscribe to this channel, and I will catch you very soon in the next one.